Hey guys, I'm Alina with Awaken Catholic, and this is Awaken the Saint. Today we celebrate the feast of a prominent English martyr, St. Thomas Becket of Canterbury. Born in London in 1118, Thomas was raised by middle-class parents and excelled in his education. He's described as athletic, having enjoyed hawking and hunting, and oftentimes was noted as being a little impetuous and strong-willed. But according to testimonies from his confessor, Thomas was an overall virtuous and upstanding man. When he was 24, he began working for the Archbishop of Canterbury. This spurred him into pursuing a full-time career in the church. Eventually, his ambition and hard work brought him to work directly with young King Henry II. The two hit it off quite well, and it's said that the pair worked together on matters of the church and state with one mind. When the archbishop passed away, Thomas was nominated to take his place. He truly didn't want the position, primarily because he knew it would drive a wedge between him and his king friend. Thomas is quoted saying, "Should God permit me to be the Archbishop of Canterbury, I would soon lose your majesty's favor, and the affection with which you honor me would be changed into hatred. For there are several things you do now in prejudice of the rights of the church, which make me fear you would require of me what I could not agree to, and envious persons would not fail to make it the occasion of endless strife between us." But the king didn't listen and made Thomas Archbishop of Canterbury. Things went downhill for the duo after that. Taking his new position in the church very seriously, Thomas would not acquiesce to King Henry the way the old archbishop had. He couldn't, in good conscience, allow the king to pass laws or decrees that would go against the church. It would seem that these new responsibilities called Thomas to a higher standard, and this didn't sit well with the king. Envious foes whispered into the king's ear, pushing the friends further and further apart. Until at last, in a moment of wrath and exasperation, King Henry cried, "Will no one rid me of this troublesome priest?" Evidently, he didn't intend this to happen, but four of his all-too-eager knights took his words seriously. They murdered Thomas Becket in his own cathedral, stabbing him through the skull. When the king heard what happened, he was so upset. He fasted in his chambers for 40 days, and later performed public penance at the Canterbury Cathedral, where his friend had been murdered. 3 years later, Thomas Becket was canonized a saint. When we experience true conversion, some things in our lives simply cannot stay the same. I know someone who converted to Catholicism in college and had to let go of some really close friends because they tempted him to sin. His old friends didn't understand why he'd changed so much, and hurtful things were said on their part. Kind of like with King Henry and Thomas, their friendship wasn't necessarily based on challenging each other to holiness. It was simply for good times and shallow laughs. The life of St. Thomas shows us a man who is willing to do right in the eyes of God, even if it meant frustrating his superior, and even more painfully, losing his friend. May we have such courage for our church today. St. Thomas Becket, ora pro nobis.